Hi everyone, this is Massimo Bottura and this is Why Waste with Fine Dining Lovers. We're gonna talk about pasta, rice and bread. Bread. To me, bread is gold. You have to ask the right question to these ingredients. This is not a just baked bread. This is like 3 days, 4 days bread. And so what I can do for you, what you can do for me, that's the point. The mental palate is changing everything. But to do this, I'm gonna introduce you Francesco Vincenzi, detto Vince. He walked into Francescana 11 years ago and he never left. Now he's the chef at Franceschetta, 58, and he's one of the best young Italian chefs. I'm gonna challenge him to do something special with the bread crust that is the most difficult things to use because it's like, it's very intense when he's concentrate like that. So what you can do with that?
How about sticky sweet cake made from bread crust, some amaretto biscuits, a little piece of chocolate, and some hazelnut.
Hazelnut, biscuit, chocolate. All right, right. Come on, let's try. Bravo, Vecchio. Dai, vai, Vecchio, vai.
Let's go.
Vai, vai.
For this recipe, you will need 200 grams of breadcrumbs, 200 grams amaretto biscuits, 15 grams sugar, 3 eggs, 150 grams chocolate, 300 grams cream, 70 grams of Sassolino spirits, 16 grams baking powder, 100 grams of any nuts that you have. First step, take a bowl and whisk together the sugar and the eggs until well mixed. Now, we add the cream and Sassolino liqueur. Fold in the breadcrumbs for all the bread you have had lying around. The last few pieces from the plate. The crust at the end. They will soak up the delicious cream and liqueur. Finally, we add amaretti cookies and chocolate. Now I'm going to add some nuts and baking powder. Pour into a greased pan and bake in the oven at 180 degrees for around 35 minutes or until a cake tester comes out clean. Smells delicious. I prefer to serve this cake cold, but it's up to you.
Did you know that 286 million tons of pasta, rice, and bread cereals in general are wasted every year? Can you imagine? The foundation of Italian cuisine are wasted. That's insane. It's not possible. Step out of your kitchens and be the change. No more excuses. Every time I hear those numbers, I feel shame. That's why in our restaurants, we have a cultural exercise every day with all the stagiaires, the commis, the chefs to work and to cook the food waste and transform food waste into amazing meals for staff. So it's like the refettorio of our restaurants are a cultural, a creative places in which we fight our food waste. In this series, my team, one from Modena, one from North America, one from Mexico, one from Japan, will teach you what to do with all this kind of food that is not just always food waste or surplus that you bought and you don't use it, but also you don't style correctly. So, you know, they're gonna teach you this kind of approach that is cultural, but also ethic approach. Because, you know, contemporary cuisine is not just about aesthetic, it's ethic and aesthetic together. Because throwing away not used food is a tragedy. Here, you're gonna learn some storage tips. It's very important to always have in mind that when you walk into the kitchen, you can walk in, chop, saute, and serve, or you can walk in and start dreaming. So one of the most amazing and potential thing is keep always a space for poetry in which you can jump and imagine a potato peels, some breadcrumbs, some Parmigiano rinds, and transform into amazing meals. Always remember that we, as chef, where people see leftover, we make visible the invisible. We see potential. We see something already amazing. We transform into beauty. Because, you know, with beauty, we cannot make a revolution. But one day, the revolution will need beauty when you have to rebuild. So the beauty of creativity is what really is the potential to transform a Parmigiano-Reggiano crust into something emotional. So Vince, we have leftover pasta. What we can do with that?
I choose to do pasticcio. It's a traditional and local dishes.
It's the pasta of the day after.
Absolutely. This is a pie of everything. So you can choose whatever you want to put inside. Open your fridge, choose the ingredients like vegetable, meat, cheese, and make this macaroni pie to finish to cook in the oven.
So remember, it's extremely important, your mental palate. Your mental palate is telling you, is talking to you. So be focused, listen to him. And I love the word everything. The word everything is so powerful. So use the word everything, manage the word everything with delicatezza, because it's extremely important, but extremely dangerous.
This dish is a great way to use up all leftovers, not just pasta. In Italy, we call it pasticcio, but I like to call it macaroni pie. It's perfect for using any type of the leftovers you have in the fridge. There's no rules here. 400 grams of leftover macaroni and tomato sauce. 100 grams of leftover beef brisket. 17 grams of beef tongue, but you can change however you like. 50 grams of carrots, 17 grams of broccoli, 30 grams of peas, 120 grams of bechamel, 10 grams of butter, 10 grams of flour, a pinch of nutmeg, 100 grams of milk, pre-made pie dough, and salt and Parmigiano Reggiano to taste. Step 1, melt some butter and slowly add flour. We stir this to make a roux. Once the roux is formed, slowly add some milk. You will start to see the mixture thicken. Now we add a pinch of salt, pinch of nutmeg, and Parmigiano Reggiano. Now we pour in the leftover pasta, vegetables and meat. Mix together well and add grated Parmigiano to taste. Remember, you can use any leftover you find in your fridge. Line a greased baking pan with pie dough and pour the mixture in. Cover the top with more dough. Finally, we add some egg wash on top and two holes to let out the steam. Now we bake it in the oven at 180 degrees for 30 minutes.
So, my friend, are you ready?
Yes, of course.
A pie, in this case, is like a container of ideas. The day after macaroni is even better than the one you are serving. But you have to ask the right question to the ingredients. Macaroni, you're one day old. What can I do? What can I do for you? And the macaroni is gonna answer to you and is gonna say, I want to go in the pie. I'm gonna have the second chance for my second life. This is the second life. Buonissimo. Vecchio. Francesco used the same mind that my grandmother would use, but filtered by a contemporary mind. Because you want to be contemporary, you have to know everything and forget about everything. But first of all, you have to know everything. Otherwise, you're not contemporary. And at that point, you travel with your ears and eyes open, but never forget who you are and where you come from. And Francesco coming from Modena, a place where ethic and the static has always been there. A place where if we stay together, we are stronger. A place where you don't have to waste one single bones from the animal that is giving his life for you and to feed the family for the whole year. You have to pay respect. It's a spiritual action. I'm enjoying my macaroni pie. Did you know that there are almost 800 million people, they don't have anything to eat. This is why me and my wife, Lara, create Food for Soul, a no-profit organization to fight food waste and social isolation. Through what? Through beauty, because beauty will change the world. This project is about sharing, because it's a cultural project. It's not charity. One of the UN goals is to have food waste in the globe by 2030. This is not gonna happen if we are not all involved in this, all together in this amazing project. Why waste? Hey guys, share your creation now on Fine Dining Lovers, hashtag why waste. You have to do it. I've been watching you.